The Presidio of San Francisco has been a fortress since the late 18th century. First for Spanish explorers, then Mexico, and lastly for the United States Army. It became a beacon of strength and a refuge from storms. A camp for refugees after the quake of 1906. It is the final resting place for veterans of two world wars. It was a training facility, a field hospital. And since 1989, it has served as a national park. Mark Matheson first discovered this place on October 10th, 1996. So, it makes sense that on this, the day of his father's funeral, Mark would return to this spot where no one could find him, except for Gillian.
You want me to go with you?
I know, I'll just be a second. You stay here?
Yeah.
Okay. Gillian Broche had not seen Mark in 2 years. She wondered what it would feel like. If her first glance would be a painful one. Or would it light her up the way it used to? Would he be glad to see her? Would she smile and lie? Tell him that she had been doing great? Would they have anything left to say to each other? Would they just sit in silence, waiting for one of them to move? She didn't know.
Mark, are you okay? Were you really gonna leave without saying anything to me?
I always loved the view of the bridge from up here. Read about a guy who lost his job, and he jumped. But he lived. And can you imagine what was going through his head? You think he was relieved or disappointed?
You know, I don't know, Mark. Is that really what you want to talk about?
I don't want to talk about anything.
I think that we should. Are you really gonna leave without saying anything?
I didn't feel like sticking around to hear my uncles talk about what a good man he was.
I thought it was a nice turnout.
He had a few drinking buddies, I'll give him that. Or maybe they just share the Episcopalian's passion for fiction.
I thought it was a nice service.
Why are you here?
She invited me.
Who?
Your grandmother.
That figures. Well, thank you for coming. I'm sure it meant a lot to her.
Do you need anything?
No.
I thought about you the other day. I was cleaning out my office and I found one of my old notebooks. It had our first interview in it. Do you remember?
No, I don't remember that.
He was lying. Mark remembered every detail.
Jeff?
Yeah?
Can you come taste this, please?
What is that, thyme?
Yeah.
No, it's too much.
You told me to use that in the sauce.
It doesn't matter what I told you. You should know what I was thinking, right? Yeah?
Qui non te ascolto.
What was that?
Oh, I said I love you.
That's what I thought.
Chef, this is Miss...
Gillian Broche.
Right, this is Chef Mark Matheson.
Gillian.
Yes.
Yeah, we've actually met before.
We have?
Yeah, Sonoma. Last summer, my friends Nancy and Carol had a tasting for their new red.
Oh, yeah.
You were there with...
Paul.
Paul, that's right. And how is Paul?
I wouldn't know.
Oh, sorry to hear that.
Right, well, this is adorable. What do you have for us, Miss Broche?
Well, I do have a few preliminary designs based on the measurements I received.
Huh. It's modern. That is what we talked about, right?
Can I be honest?
Of course.
This isn't my best work.
Well, if it's not your best work, then what are you doing here?
Peter.
Look, miss, we are very busy, and for you to come in here
Peter,
with a half-ass...
Can I see a menu?
What for?
Well, because the food's very important to me. It's kind of hard to get a sense of the space without understanding the flavor profile.
I'll go grab one. There you go.
Something wrong, Miss Broche?
Well, no, I see you have a tartare, caprese salad, these are your recipes.
That's right.
What sets your menu apart?
Apart from what?
No offense, but this is the most ubiquitous menu I've ever seen.
Who do you think you are? You realize we're the clients, right?
What sets it apart, Miss Broche? Is that I'm the one making it.
Okay. What does that mean to people?
Did you come here to insult us or design a restaurant?
Okay, look, no offense, but this is not what inspires people. I was hired because I have bold ideas that go beyond what the color of the sconces are. So if you want this place to look like every other restaurant in America, then hire someone else. But if you want this place to have soul, let me help you find it.
How many restaurants have you designed in San Francisco?
This is my first one.
Okay, I think we're done here. Thank you for coming.
Wait, Peter. I want to hear what she has to say.
Can I talk to you a moment, privately?
1 minute.
You have to get rid of her.
Why? I like her.
Are you insane? She has no idea what she's doing.
And I want to see where that takes us.
I can't believe you're even entertaining the idea of letting
Look, her... what choice do we have, okay? We're over budget, we're over time. I mean, you want to wait another 6 months? I say we just give her a shot.
Oh, really? Mark Matheson wants to give her a shot.
Yes.
You're so predictable.
Look, who else is going to do it?
It can't be that hard.
Break. You know what? I gave you the wine list. I gave you the name. Just give me this one thing, Pete. Please.
Fine. But if I don't like what she does, I get a veto.
Of course.
And don't call me Pete.
Sure, whatever.
Hey. Don't let her get in your head. We are not changing the menu.
Gillian?
Hi.
Hey.
Thanks for meeting.
Yeah, of course, no problem. Are you sure you don't want me to cook for you?
Oh, no, not yet. I want you to show me around first.
Show you around? Like the city?
Not quite. Let's say you had 2 hours left.
To do what?
To live. Giant monster's gonna come through the city and destroy it.
Okay. I can only pick one?
Yes.
I can't stop and grab a drink?
No.
Okay. All right, I got one.
You got one?
Yeah.
Okay, what is it?
Well, why don't I just show you?
Okay.
Come on.
You brought me here.
I remember.
I think it made all the difference.
For what?
The design.
It was your game. I was just playing along.
It was more than that.
I don't know what you want me to say. I mean, day one, I could talk to you like, I've never talked to anybody like that.
Neither have I.
Well, it's very unorthodox.
But I got some good stuff. So it worked out pretty well.
So what's next? You're gonna walk all the way to Sausalito with Peter?
No. He owns half that restaurant, but he's not the heart of that place. You are.
But you don't like my food.
I've never tasted your food. And besides, the restaurant has to be a reflection of who you are, and I'm trying to figure that out.
Oh, so you think you got me figured out, huh?
I have a head start.
So I take you to a park and Japanese place, and all of a sudden you've got me pegged?
Cooking is the only thing that makes sense to you. Your dad was a chef. And that seems to be the only thing you don't resent about him. You've got a chip on your shoulder because you seem to think that he owes you something. You opened a restaurant out of revenge, but I think deep down you really love it. You think that you're better than he is. You're pretty much better than anyone you've ever cooked for. And now it's time for the world to take notice. You're cocky, but it's only because you think you have to be. You kind of wear it like an apron, but I can tell by the way that you talk about food and eat food. It's not because it's about being the best. It's about love. And I think you think that if you have that, you'll never be alone.
Wow, you wrote all that in your book?
Some of it, sorry.
No. Don't be.
I should go.
So, I guess we'll, see you in a couple weeks.
Yeah, I could draw something up as soon as possible.
Well, thank you for lunch. And dinner. And drinks.
You're welcome, Mark.
Good night, Gillian.
Good night, Mark.
Okay.
Morning.
You been here all night?
Yeah. Come taste this.
Saffron.
Huh?
What are you doing?
We're changing the menu.
Four months later, smoke and fire opened in the Mission District. With a fresh and personal design by Gillian and an updated menu, Mark felt inspired. He just had to get through opening night.
Our job is to earn their trust. Pretension, snobbery, and asshattery are not what we are about. These these guests are going to be paying $100 an entree. We want them to feel like it's worth it.
Hi, welcome to Smoke and Fire, table for two?
Yeah.
Right this way, please.
We cater to each individual, not the table. So know every detail of every dish. We want them to feel special. We want them to feel loved. And we want them to feel like they are sitting at the most exclusive table in the city.
Good evening, welcome to Smoke and Fire. Table for two? Just follow me.
We've given you all the tools you need to be successful. Show us that you are a part of this family. Chef Mark has something to say.
When Peter and I started this journey, we had one goal in mind: perfection. That is the standard that we hold ourselves to. Anything less than that is unacceptable. We have you here because we know that you have that capacity. Maybe in other restaurants you worked in, your best was good enough, but not here. Here, every dish that comes out of this kitchen is flawless. It's beyond reproach. If not, we don't serve it. So you give me that. You give me perfect, and I will give you something better than that. You will be working in the best kitchen in this city, and you'll be able to say that with confidence. And one day, when you all have your own kitchens, you sprout wings and fly, you'll hold yourself to that same standard. You'll want to be better than me. You'll fail miserably. But the pursuit will be noble. Be perfect. Anything less is unacceptable. Let's cook. Let's get some music going.
Don't look so grim.
How'd we do?
How do you think?
I don't know. The whole night was a blur.
We had a line out the door all night. We're booked solid for the next month. We did it, Mark. We should celebrate. You
yes.
know we should.
Congratulations, Chef.
Thank you. I am starving. let's get a family meal going, yeah?
Okay. What do you want?
Do we have any cherry stones left?
I think so.
Chipino, I made a stock earlier. It's in the walk-in.
Sounds good.
Thank you.
I tried to get a table earlier, but the line was around the block.
Oh, you don't have to wait, just call. You never have to wait for a table.
Okay. I brought you something.
What?
When you told me about your grandma and how she raised you and how much you love her, it made me think about my grandma, and I just,
wow.
I don't know. She collects them, and I just thought, I know it's stupid.
No. I love it. I'll cherish it always. Listen, I can't thank you enough for all this. I mean, it looks incredible.
That's my job.
Yeah, but I never could have imagined this.
Yeah, sure you could have. You were just so focused on what you didn't want this place to be. You didn't see it for what it could be.
guess that's true.
Most people think like that, though.
Like what?
Well, if they know the answer to everything, or if they think they know everything, they don't try. But if you live your life like that, you'll never be surprised.
Well, I hope I'm not like that.
I don't think you are.
You're saying I don't know the outcome to things?
No, I'm saying you don't act like you do. You wouldn't have opened this place if you were that insightful.
So now this place is destined to fail?
Okay, wait, that's not what I meant. I just... I meant that I admire you for taking such risks.
Mm. Well, I had good help.
Well, now you're being modest.
I've been accused of a lot of things, never that.
I have to go. I have an early meeting in the morning.
Yes, of course. Well, thank you again, Gillian.
You're welcome.
Hey.
Night.
Jill?
Yeah.
Do you think you
found it? Bought a Montreal ice cream. I've been saving it for.
Oh, Gillian. I know you're here. Would you like some?
Oh, no, thank you.
Nonsense. It's a 98.
No, seriously, I'm okay. I just. You want to drop something off for Mark?
Charming. Not for the dining room, I hope. What?
Peter, why don't you take this back in the kitchen and we'll crack it open with the entire staff.
Did you hear me when I said it was a 98?
I will pay you back. Just go and I will see Gillian out.
Gillian, it was a pleasure working with you.
You too.
The place looks better than I expected.
Thank you.
I think that's the closest you're ever going to get to a compliment for him.
I'll take it. Goodness, I really do have to go, though.
Okay. Well, good night. Good night.
Okay. And the answer is yes, by the way.
As to what?
Whatever you're gonna ask me, I'd love to. What would you have said?
I don't know.
If I hadn't said anything, would you have done anything?
You mean if I knew the outcome?
That's not fair.
You're the one who said it. People know the outcome of things, they don't do anything, so... No, if I knew how it would all pan out, I don't think I would have done anything.
I think you would have. You might have let me walk out the door, sure, but I don't think you would have let me around that corner. You would have stopped me.
Doesn't matter now.
Yes, it does. It still matters to me anyway.
Two days after Jillian's visit to the restaurant, Mark picked her up for their first date. Mark was nervous, and Jillian tried on 6 different outfits before he arrived. They had lunch at an oyster bar and talked like old friends who hadn't seen each other in years. Sun faded into dark, finding them holding hands in the Embarcadero. The lights from the pier lit Jillian's face. Soft rain fell as Mark pulled her in and kissed her for the first time. Like any other great first kiss, it multiplied itself again and again for days and then weeks. until Mark could only be found in one of two places: the kitchen of his restaurant, or within a 3-foot radius of Gillian Broche.
This is delicious. Is it gonna be like this every morning?
If you want it to be.
I'm not sharing.
Oh, I already ate.
My mom used to make breakfast like this. Every morning, me and my sister, we'd wake up to pancakes and eggs. We had a tangerine tree in the backyard, and the juicer was kind of like our alarm clock. But then my sister, when she went to high school, she met this kid. It was bad news. He introduced her to drugs, and first it was pills. I just tried everything. Yeah, it got so bad that My parents thought it was a good idea to put her in a clinic, but she hated him for it. She actually tried to kill herself. My mom stopped cooking breakfast, and we stopped talking. We haven't talked really since. I mean, my sister's better now. She lives in Arizona. She's married. Even my parents, they don't talk much. They're more like roommates than a couple. And it sounds lame, but I swore that if I ever had kids, we would have breakfast every morning, no matter what. Because the moment we stopped having breakfast was the moment we stopped being a family.
Thank you.
I've tried so hard to make my eggs taste like that. I fail every time.
And I'm sure Jeremy would just burn the water if he even tried to boil it.
Jeremy, he's the guy that you... You know what? Don't answer that. I don't care.
Sorry.
Why did you bring him?
You wanted to be supportive, I guess.
That is not why he came. He came so you could parade him around and I would see it. And I would know that I lost.
He's not that vindictive.
Everyone is that vindictive. You know that or you wouldn't have brought him.
Should I just leave?
I didn't ask you to come in the first place.
I'll just go then.
Gillian, wait. Don't go.
You know, I hate when you do that. You say the worst possible thing in the moment just to make me feel bad. And you know what? I do it too. When did that start?
I don't know.
Well, we didn't used to.
Yes, Sophia. Oh, Chef?
What?
He's here for you. I'm sorry, what's your name again?
Colin Kendrick.
Hi.
Who are you?
I'm with the Bay City Arts.
Oh. What is that?
It's the online magazine. I spoke to Peter Strand.
Oh. Pete! What is this about?
Oh, it's a feature article I'm writing about up-and-coming restaurants in the area renovating old landmarks.
What are you oinking at, Mark? Oh. Mr. Kendrick, looking forward to this.
Just make sure phones are on airplane mode, please.
Already done.
All right.
What is that for?
Oh, it's a video. Is that all right?
For a magazine?
It's an online magazine.
It's fine.
Okay. Smoke and Fire. Where did the name come from?
Well, I came up with it, actually. It's a metaphor of sorts. We wanted to spread word of mouth about the restaurant and talk the talk, but also walk the walk. And I guess both of us thought that the name gave us a little swagger.
So it has nothing to do with your culinary methods?
Well, we use smoke and fire, so, yeah.
Have you been happy with word of mouth so far?
Yeah. Yeah, I think so. We wanted a place that wasn't very touristy or a novelty restaurant, but one that could really build a solid reputation.
So, who is Chef Mark Matheson?
I don't understand the question.
Forget I asked. So, your father was a very important chef in California. How does he feel about you following into his footsteps?
Well, I wouldn't say I was following in his footsteps. I like to think Peter and I are doing our own thing.
Did he give you any advice about opening up your own restaurant?
I didn't ask Granny.
How does he feel about the menu?
I'm sorry. What is this article about?
Mark.
No, it's fine.
Smoke and fire. Look, our readers want
to know. No. But you've done your homework, right? I mean, you know the whole background. I mean, is that really what your readers want to know about?
Look, I think our readers would be interested to know why the son of Bruce Matheson opens up a restaurant in the same building he did 30 years ago.
Oh, they would, huh? Excuse me. I have to take this. Hey.
Would you like a tour of the kitchen?
What's wrong? Where are you?
The client yelled at me. She said that I painted it the wrong color even though I showed her the swatch 3 separate times. She said yes, I wouldn't have painted it if she hadn't signed off on it. So she's yelling at me. And she tells me that I'm trying to sabotage her store, which is stupid, because why would I sabotage my own client's store, right? So then I told her that she was just miserable and bitter about her own life, and I told her where she can shove it, which I should...
I'm sorry. Keep going.
So she told my boss, and of course he wasn't there, so he couldn't hear how she was talking to me, but I should... Yeah, I shouldn't have said what I said. I'm stupid.
So what happened?
I got fired.
Oh, sweetheart. I'm sorry.
You know what the worst thing is? I just signed a new lease. I'm gonna have to get a smaller place, or even worse, a roommate. You know, I thought moving here was gonna be a fresh start for me, you know? I've always wanted to design in San Francisco. It's been my dream.
Whoa. It still is. I mean, yes, it sucks you got fired. I get that, but you don't have to give up, and you certainly don't need... You don't need anybody to be your boss.
What are you talking about?
Start your own firm.
Okay.
I'm serious. I mean, you have the talent, you have the drive. Start your own business. Be your own boss.
Mark, I just got fired from my job. I'm probably gonna lose the apartment. Right now doesn't seem the best time to start my own firm.
It's the perfect time to start your own firm. You have nothing to lose.
Except no one's gonna hire me when I'm living on a bench in Golden Gate Park.
If you're really that worried about being homeless, then move in with me.
Sure, let me just grab my toothbrush.
I'm serious, Jill. Move in with me.
No, Mark, I'm really not in the mood.
I'm not joking. Move in with me.
We barely know each other.
We know enough.
Okay. So then what was my high school mascot?
Wildcats?
How'd you know that?
Because everyone's high school mascot is Wildcats.
Okay. The Beatles are Elvis.
But...
All right, so this one might be the deal breaker.
Okay, lay it on me.
In the last presidential election, I voted Republican. Why?
You know, I am not that political.
Damn it.
Yeah, I'm a little insulted. It sounds like you're coming up with excuses not to move in with me.
Give me one good reason why I should.
Because I'm in love with you.
What?
I love you, Jill.
But you can't say that.
Why not?
Because you can't tell a girl that you love her on her bad day.
Oh, I was gonna tell you anyway.
bad day is just good timing.
But that's really dangerous. You can't take that back.
I don't want to take it back. I meant it.
You sure?
I'm sure. I think it was the moment you called my menu ubiquitous.
I did say that.
Yeah.
That was rude.
It was honest. And I'm being honest. I'm in love with you. And I want you to move in with me, not because you need to, but because I want you to.
I'm not ready to say it back.
I can wait.
Are you sure? I have a lot of clothes.
I have a lot of closet space.
Welcome to Smoke and Fire. Your name?
LeBlanc, for one.
Of course, Mr. LeBlanc. Right this way. Your table is waiting.
Yes, yes, thank you.
Tuna with bok choy quinoa and soy reduction.
Land, medium, on the fly, let's go!
Guys, we got table number 7, VIP, Gavin Newsom. Fire the ribeye, medium rare, please. We got 1 veg plate, no garlic. Thank you.
Sophia.
Yeah, what is it?
LeBlanc is here.
Chef.
What?
LeBlanc is here.
Sure?
Peter San.
Don't tell anyone.
Okay.
Hey, wait. What do we do? Correction every time, right?
Yes.
Okay. Keep it tight. When the order comes out, you and I plate it.
Yes, chef.
Okay, let's go.
If I could make a recommendation.
I'll have the caramelized romaine and the avocado toast. And for my entree, I'll have the lamb.
Very good, sir. Those are excellent choices. May I send the sommelier out for your wine selection tonight?
Ah. Chef's choice, I think. Have Mark surprise me.
Very good.
The order is in. I don't need to tell you that
Peter,
this one is gonna be.
Get out of my kitchen. I got this. Okay, we got the toast, romaine. I'm gonna take the chops to get the starters.
Yes, chef.
Yeah, good.
He wants you to select the wine.
Bordeaux. Nothing younger, no 3.
Another one.
Okay. All right.
Let's go. Get garbage. No shit.
fix that. It should be black. Okay, good. Take it. Service.
Then it was Christmas. As they drove down the coast, Mark realized Gillian was nervous. He was the first man she had ever brought home.
Okay, don't be nervous. Are you nervous? You look nervous.
I'm not. Relax.
Well, I'm sorry, it's just that my parents can be a little... You know what I mean?
No, not really.
Okay, well, just remember to be, you know... Hi!
Hello, darling. Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, Mom!
Hi, sweetie.
Dad, this is my, Mark.
Hi. Nice to meet both of you. I've heard a lot about you.
Well, I wish we could say the same. Can I take that from you?
No.
I insist.
I'll just get the bags. Find some traffic. Lay down in front.
I'm sorry the chicken is dry.
It's fine, Mom.
I liked it. Did you put gorgonzola in the potatoes?
I did. My grandmother's trick.
I like it a lot. Thank you.
So, sweetheart, how's the new job?
It's,
Naomi, I'm stealing these green beans.
Actually, it's not, Dad. They let me go.
They what? Why?
It was a misunderstanding.
Oh, that didn't take long.
Chris!
It's more complicated than that.
You know, what are you doing for money?
Excuse me?
You live in the Bay Area. How are you paying for rent?
Well, right now I'm living with Mark.
I'm sorry?
Gillian.
What? Wait. How long have...
Dad.
Is her fireplace on?
You know, I would expect this from your sister, but from you...
Chris, can we please just have a nice meal?
Sweetheart, why in the hell did we send her to design school when all she's gonna do is just lose her job and shack up with Bobby Flay over here?
Dad, you're not even giving me a chance
to... I'd like to propose a toast. To Chris and Naomi, thank you for having us here on Christmas and sharing hearth and whatever. Chris, thank you for the Bobby Flay comment. I'm pretty sure it was meant as an insult, but he is a national treasure, so thanks for that. Naomi, thank you for the potatoes. Again, amazing. And to Gillian, the sweetest, kindest, most loving person I've ever met in my life. May you have all the love you've shown return to you tenfold. And may you never let the pessimism of experience get in the way of following your dreams and passions. I just hope I can be there along for the ride. Merry Christmas, sweetheart. Merry Christmas. God bless us, everyone. Happy Kwanzaa. Excuse me. Okay, look, before you say anything.
Thank you.
Wait, so you're not mad?
Oh no, I'm a little mad. Don't ever do that again.
Got it.
Okay. That's the scarf you wanted, right, Mom?
Yes, I love it. So soft. Mark, do you like the cookbook?
I do. Thank you very much.
I thought you might find some good ideas in there. Things that you haven't thought of.
I'm sure I will.
I look forward to reading it. Thank you.
How come you don't have a cookbook, Mark?
Well, I don't want to give away all my secrets. I'd be out of a job.
I heard your dad was a chef. Did he have a cookbook?
I believe so, yeah.
Well, I made a pumpkin pie. Would anyone like some?
I'd love some.
Chris?
Mm-hmm.
Will you help me?
Sure. Excuses.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error.
Well, I think I'm officially ruined for pie. What's wrong?
I was gonna wait until Christmas to tell you, but I think I'll just tell you now.
What?
Why am I so nervous? Wow, why am I nervous?
I don't know, but it's kind of adorable.
I'm just gonna say it. I'm just gonna...
Jillian, whatever... Shh.
You're actually making this much worse. Okay. Mark. I'm in love with you.
Is that a question?
Oh, look, I'm sorry. I'm just gonna... I'm gonna try that again. I am in love with you.
You're in love with me.
Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
Just so we're on the same page, you love me and I love you, that means we're in love.
Yes, I think so. Well, what's wrong?
Wrong? Nothing's wrong. I'm starting to get a clear view of what the rest of my life looks like.
What's that?
Us?
I think that's what surprised me the most.
What?
I didn't realize I'd have that much fun with you.
I could just be myself.
Yeah, sometimes I wonder if... Never mind.
What? No.
I wonder if things would be different if you hadn't read that review.
Maybe. I don't know.
What are we doing today?
Whatever you want. Oh, I do have to pick up some salmon that I ordered.
Ooh, fish market. How long's that gonna take?
Only be an hour. Hey.
Can you believe what the bastard wrote about us?
Wait. What?
What? Have you not read your morning paper yet? Can you believe we opened a bottle of 98 for this guy?
Hold on.
Mark? What is it?
I'll call you back.
Mark, wait.
What? Smoke and Fire, a tired and pretentious eatery in the saturated Mission District, opens with a menu so bland, you find yourself wishing the place would live up to its name and clear the room with smoke and fire. Mark. Oh.
Read it.
Chef Mark Matheson, son of infamous Chef Bruce Matheson, shows that while he does not have his father's penchant for controversy, he also does not share his palate for exceptional cuisine. Yeah, I don't want to read this anymore, Mark.
Just read it, Jill.
The only thing more uninspiring than Matheson's rustic and sloppy menu is the decor, which is a cross between a Swedish furniture store and a funeral home. The wine list has little imagination, but contains just enough alcohol to get you through dinner. Two stars. You know what? This is just bad writing. No, don't listen to anything that she's got to say.
He says. He.
Okay, who's Michelle Blanc?
Michelle LeBlanc is the only voice in food that matters.
Okay, well, people love your place. They won't pay any attention to that.
He just signed our death certificate. As soon as people read that, reses will drop, and we'll have empty tables on the weekends.
Because of one bad review? This guy clearly has it out for you.
Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if he's right or wrong. It only matters that he said it. And now, anyone looking for my place is gonna read that.
Okay, so prove him wrong.
How?
Yeah, I don't know. Fight him back. You know, the guy is just bitter because the internet killed journalism, and any idiot with a smartphone can throw shade and say whatever they want about food. But we both know that that's crap. We know that your food's amazing. That places you from the ground up. He can say whatever he wants, but he can't fault that design.
Yeah, well, if you're such a good designer, why'd you get fired?
Okay, don't say that to me. I get that you're hurt, but you don't get to say things that make me feel bad. I'm trying to help.
Well, you've helped enough.
Wow.
For a few days after that, the apartment was filled with the silence of things left unsaid. moved around cautiously. As if the slightest sound would upset the other. It was only questions about taking out the garbage or buying milk. Mark was ashamed. Gillian was crushed. And laughter had left without a trace.
Gillian.
What?
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said it. I didn't mean it.
What are you doing?
These weren't clean.
So get someone else to clean them.
Well, no. I'll do it, since nobody bothers to do their job around here.
Oh, I get it.
What? What do you get?
You're still salty about the review? Move on.
Move on? How many reses canceled this week?
25.
25? But hey, let's move on.
Yeah, you want to run a restaurant? You better grow a pair. People are going to complain. You want to pout about it? Go home and pout to Gillian. I'm not your wife.
I can't go home.
Why not?
Because I'm an idiot.
Oh. So say you're sorry.
I already tried. Not a word all week.
Listen, Mark. Go home. Fix it. You're depressing the hell out of everyone in the kitchen. I'll take care of this stuff.
Jill? Jillian. What's wrong?
I'm late.
Late for what?
I mean, I'm late.
How late?
2 weeks.
How is that even? Did you take a test?
No.
Well,
not yet, 2 minutes.
Is it done yet? What does it say?
Not pregnant.
You'd taken the test before you said anything to me.
Right, Mark, so I could be all afraid by myself.
What are you so pissed about? I thought you'd be relieved.
You know, I don't know how I feel, but I would expect a little bit more support from you.
You don't think I support you?
You could at least try not to act so thrilled when you find out you're not gonna have a baby with me.
Why would I not be? Are you telling me you wouldn't freak out right now if we were pregnant?
I'd be terrified. I'm not ready for that, but I'm just saying that the prospect of it...
What? What?
If I had to be a mom, I'd want it to be with you. And I take it from your silence, you don't feel the same way.
That's not fair. We've never even had a conversation about
it. Now's a good time as any.
No, that is a bad idea, not when we're so emotional.
You're right, Mark. We should have this conversation when I'm not emotional. Yeah, good luck with that.
You've never even talked about it. We've never had... You've never mentioned having a kid.
Just because I've never talked about it doesn't mean it hasn't crossed my mind. 10 minutes ago, I thought I was going to be a mom. And now that I'm not, I just...
What?
I don't know. I felt disappointed. I just want you to talk to me. I don't know if I want to have a baby. I don't, but I just... I wonder how you would feel about it.
About what?
About us being parents.
I never wanted that.
Never. You've never wondered what it would be like to have another person that's half you, the best parts of you running around in their own little world, never?
Who said they would have the best parts? You know, not everybody's kid turns out to be student of the month. Or what if the kid was like your sister? Is that what you want?
Don't do that. Don't bring our families into this. You know, lots of people have troubled pasts and they still turn out to be amazing. You can't use that as an excuse every time you're scared.
I'm not scared.
Yes, you are. Your dad was a drunk, so what? You're not like him.
Is a drunk. Present tense. And he's not my dad. He was barely a donor. Not that my mom was any better. The only decent thing she ever did for me was stay clean for 9 months so I didn't end up broken. The woman who raised me didn't even want me. I was forced upon her. She didn't have a choice.
But you do.
And I'm not going to apologize for knowing what I want. I have always known what I want, and playing dad on the weekends was never a part of the deal. I mean, is that really what you want? To be like your parents? To have a kid who's genetically prone to alcoholism and suicidal tendencies? Sign me up.
I'm sorry. You think the idea of having a kid with me is so off-putting.
I thought we were on the same page.
We were.
So, where does that leave us?
wish I could change you.
Wow.
I have to talk to you. Last night I got a phone call from my friend from school. She said that her firm is taking on new designers, and she asked me if I wanted an interview. It's in Sacramento. I think I'm gonna take it. Are you not gonna say anything?
I'm gonna take a shower. I gotta go to work.
Gillian had graduated top of her class from the Barrow School of Design. Growing up, it had always been her dream to design for a major firm in San Francisco. But as Gillian learned the night before, dreams can change.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
They offered me the job. I think I'm gonna take it. So I think we should put things on pause for a while.
pause. You're moving to Sacramento.
I think we need some time apart just to figure things out.
Figure things out. Sounds like you already figured things out for us.
I just need some time.
Take all the time you need.
Can be a long time.
A sandwich shop?
Yeah. I mean, think about it. The nail salon next door is closing. It's a perfect time to get in. Maybe, I don't know, do breakfast, lunch, limited menu, nothing fancy.
You sure you want to add extra work? I mean, we are busy enough.
We wouldn't run it. It'd just be our brand.
So sandwiches.
Yeah, sandwiches. You know, maybe on the weekends we do Sunday brunch or something. Mimosas, could do my crab eggs benedict.
Who would run it?
What about Sophia?
You think she's ready?
I think she's earned it.
I can see that. No way.
What?
You're not gonna believe who's here.
Who?
That's Michelle LeBlanc.
Oh. You're right, it is. I'm gonna go talk to him.
No, don't do that. Don't. Mark, what are you doing?
Hey. LeBlanc.
Oh, hello, Mark.
Oh, so you do know who I am?
Well, of course I do.
Well, I just came over here to let you know your little puff piece you wrote 2 years ago. It didn't work. I haven't had an empty table at my place in 9 months.
Well, congratulations. That must be so great for you.
Yes, it is. Great. What, are you trying to be funny?
Did you actually think I wanted you to fail?
It would seem that way.
That's ridiculous.
But that's what you critics do, right? I mean, you don't cook, you don't make anything. You just sit there and you
criticize?
Yes.
Thank God for that. How would you ever get any better if you were never challenged?
You are unbelievable. You actually think that review made a difference to me?
Well, of course it did.
or you wouldn't have come all the way over here after 2 years to show me how big your reservation list is.
Well, nobody cares about your little opinions. People have been lining up around the block to eat my food.
They're not lining up to eat your food, dear boy. They're lining up because you are Bruce Matheson's kid. Look, when your dad was still cooking, he made people care about food. Granted, his life was a train wreck, but in the kitchen, he was an artist. Your diners only care about what part of town they're in.
Yeah, he was pretty great. Everyone keeps telling me it's a shame. I must have missed that.
Look, I'm not his priest. I didn't say he was a good person. But when you ate his food mark, it felt honest. I wrote that review because I still had hope that one day I'll get to meet the real Chef Mark Matheson. Oh, this has been a nice chat, Mark, but this feels a little inappropriate given the circumstances.
What circumstances?
You don't know.
Know what?
You should go see your father.
Mark, oh, I'm so glad you came.
Of course.
He can't talk, but I think he can hear us.
Is this the son?
This is my grandson, Mark.
He's heavily sedated, but you can sit with him if you'd like.
Oh, no, that's okay.
You can talk to him. It can't help.
I don't.
I think that's wonderful. I'll be outside and all.
Oh, no, you don't have to.
I'll give you some time.
Okay. Thank you. She said you can hear me, but why would you start listening now, right? So I'm just going to stand here for a few minutes, and then I'm gonna open the door and let her back in the room. Because I have nothing to say to you. I'm here for her, just so you understand that. You don't look good. I guess this is what I have to look forward to, huh? It's not really fair. Mom was so pretty, but who do I look like? I wondered, do you ever see pictures of me and think, wow, it's like I'm looking in a mirror. I guess it goes both ways. I'll sit down for a minute. Just a minute. Well, here we are, Pop. Keep having this dream about Gillian and I. And we're walking in the woods. And she's holding my hand. And all of a sudden,
She runs ahead of me. And I try to go after her, but I can't catch up. She's too far ahead. No matter how hard I try, how fast I run, I can't catch her. And it's weird because I've never been there with her. I've only been there one time, and it was with you. Do you remember that? Of course you do. When I was so little, I could barely keep up with you. Or maybe it was the other way around, maybe. Maybe you couldn't keep up with me. But then you took me to a quiet place so we could talk. That's where you told me Mom was dead. And then you didn't say anything. You just stood there and let me cry. Then you walked back to the car. I never felt so alone in all my life. Felt like I was there for hours. Those trees kept getting longer and longer.
God is the Father of mercies. God does not make a judgment of us based on only one part of our life. God makes a judgment of us based on all of our life. Bruce lived a good life, always wanting the best for his family. God will see that good nature in Bruce and reward him for it. His death breaks our hearts, but we trust in God and leave him now in God's hands. Now let us pray. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, I give you my heart and my soul. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, assist me in my last agony. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, may I breathe forth my soul in peace with you. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Lord Jesus, receive my soul. Amen.
How long are you going to stay out here?
Something I gotta know. Why did you come? 2 years. I haven't seen you in 2 years. I never said a good thing about him. Why would you come to the funeral of a man you never met?
Your grandmother invited me. It sounds selfish, but I guess I just wanted to sit there and listen to all the stories about a man who had a crazy life. Lots of friends, and so many accomplishments. But messed up what could have been the best part of himself. He, You were his greatest accomplishment, and he never knew you. And I guess I just feel lucky because I didn't have you for very long. But the time that I did have you, it meant the world to me. And I guess I just wanted to say thank you. And that I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too. I'm sorry for everything.
I should go.
Jill, wait. Look, I know that you're with somebody, and I think we should go somewhere and we should talk. If we could maybe sit down and just have a coffee, that's all I'm not asking for the world here. I just need an hour to explain to you how I feel. And
Mark, I can't.
I'm not over you. Not even close. I don't know how to be. I go to bed every night, and I call out to you, and I keep thinking you're just gonna answer.
Mark,
and I
please,
just wonder
please.
If maybe you feel the same way, or you might.
I'm pregnant. I'm gonna be a mom.
Very happy for you. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. We can go home.
Eight months later, Gillian gave birth to a 7-pound baby girl. She named her Naomi for her mother. And the empty feelings she felt that day in the park was filled by a dream she didn't know she had. As time passed, she thought less and less about Mark. But every so often, she would read about popular restaurants and top chefs in the Bay Area. Mark Matheson was always on the list.
Hey. What are you doing here?
But you have a life outside this place?
I come here when I can't sleep. You know, just so I can make something.
You don't have a kitchen at your place?
Have you seen my apartment?
No.
You should come by sometime. I mean to see the kitchen. I'm sorry about your dad. I heard he was a great chef.
He was. He was a lot better than me.
You're too modest.
What are you making?
I don't know yet. My sister, she sends me these apples from Washington. They're the best. But I haven't decided what I'm going to do with them yet. Do you want to help me?
I would love to.